Hello everybody, here is Magno Borgo, and today I will talk about the Nuke FXS exporter. This exporter will allow you to send Nuke shapes to Silhouette Roto Paint. You can download the latest version always on the GitHub on this address. Okay? Download the zip, open the folder, you will get something like this. This file is the exporter script, and the menu file is, if you want to get fancy, you can install the script as a toolbar item on Nuke. You need to drop this menu PI file inside your Nuke user folder. Here I have this roto of this hand with a lot of shapes. There's tracking data, planar tracking data, there's point tracking data applied to some shapes and such. So, to run script, you need to go to the script editor, load the script, select the Roto Paint node, and here you need to be sure that the format of the node is correct, that the format is matching your Silhouette session, otherwise the shapes will not work correctly. If you are okay, go to the script editor and run script. The script will ask you for the frame range that you want to export, and also if you want to bake the shapes. Baking the shapes will insert keyframes on every frame of the exported frame range. I will not bake shapes here, and hit OK. This may take a while because the script needs to export every point, every frame, and such. So let's wait a little bit for the completion of this file. Okay, the export process is finished, so it's asking to save the file. So I will save it as myshapes.fxs. I will go to Silhouette. Here on Silhouette, I will import the Silhouette shapes, locate the file, and that's it. If I hit play, everything is working correctly. Some differences between the Nuke node and on the Silhouette project that you may notice. On Nuke, shapes can have this tracking information on them, but here on Silhouette, tracking information must be applied on layers. So you may notice some layers in between the original layer and the shapes with tracking data. The layers will be named the original name but of the shape dash track data. Okay, you can see this on these layers. If several shapes share the same tracking data, they will be placed inside the same supporting layer. Other difference is that when the position animation interpolation on Nuke is linear or hold, the keyframes will be a perfect match. But if the curves, if the animation curve is something else, you may notice more keyframes than usual. That's because the animation curves on Nuke are more complex than the Silhouette ones here on the animation system of Silhouette. So I need to introduce more keyframes. So that's it. I hope that you like the script and use it a lot. If you want to get more scripts for Silhouette, check the tools page from Boundary Visual Effects, and there's my email there as well if you want to get in touch for suggestions, development, or bug reports. Thanks for watching.